Good morning, class. Welcome to my class. Today we are going to learn a chapter named Robinson Crusoe of class 5, subject English. In this chapter we learn about a novel written by Daniel Defoe on 25 April 1790. Actually, this story, Robinson Crusoe, is a complete novel. And in today's class, we learn a small portion of this story. So, this story is a short piece from the novel Robinson Crusoe. It is a small portion. At first, we learn about the author of this story, Daniel Defoe. Daniel Defoe was born in 1660. Earlier, he worked in a butcher shop with his father till at the age of 40. So, later on, he wrote a novel, Robinson Crusoe, at the age of 60 years old, and he became more, and this novel became more popular among the children ever since. Robinson Crusoe was a novelist, was a poet, was a literary critic. He was a poet, belongs from the age of enlightenment. It means after the age of Queen Elizabeth, the age of enlightenment will start, in which the people of England become more civilized and start learning and move towards learning or education. So, this is a story of Robinson Crusoe written by Daniel Defoe. Actually, Robinson Crusoe is the character of this story. So, this story starts like that. Robinson Crusoe actually went for a ship journey with his three crew members, with his three friends, and later on his ship become destroyed in the voyage, in the sea journey, and he become the only survivor with his three members, and he went on an island and lived many years on that island and make his life possible by doing some hard work, by making house, by collecting fruits, by rearing cattle and so on. Also, he worked on art and craft, like he learned himself making pots and growing crops and so on. So, when he went on an island, on a lonely island, he felt so alone because he had no company with him. So, he made himself busy in the whole day by doing some hard work. Okay? So, this is the summary of this story. At first, now we will discuss the word meaning of this chapter. Ammunition. It means bullets, gola, barud, coarse, vein, rasa. Gigantic, huge, vishal, bada. Hurricane, a severe tropical storm. It means hawa ka bahut tez behna, means tufan. Mast, a vertical pole that supports the sails on a ship. Actually, mast is a pole in which stands in the middle of a ship to propagate ship in the direction of the air very easily. It helps the ship to propagate in the way of direction of wind. Overboard, over the side of a ship and into the water. Overboard means ship ki जहाज के साइड से पानी में या नदी में या तालाब में या समुद्र में कूद जाना, ओवरबोर्ड कर। रिजॉल्व, डिसाइडेड, विचार करना। स्टॉक टेल, अ टॉल फेंस टू कीप आउट एलिमेंट्स। एक्चुअली स्टॉकेड इज अ टाइप ऑफ हाउस विच इज वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग टू कीप आउट द वाइल्ड एनिमल्स और एनिमीज फ्रॉम अस। टॉर्नेडो, अ डिस्ट्रक्टिव फनल शेप्ड रोटेटिंग कॉलम ऑफ एयर। इट इज अ डिस्ट्रक्टिव फनल शेप लाइक दिस, फनल शेप रोटेटिंग एयर। बवंडर, वेसल, अ शिप, जहाज। ओके, दिस इज द वर्ड मीनिंग ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। लेट्स स्टार्ट द पोएम, लेट्स स्टार्ट द स्टोरी टेक्स्ट बाय टेक्स्ट। ओके, सो दिस स्टोरी स्टार्ट विद अ जर्नी ऑफ शिप ऑन अ सी। ओके, रॉबिनसन क्रूसो, वी स्टार्टेड ऑफ ऑन आवर वॉयेज इन गुड वेदर, ऑल्दो इट वॉज वेरी हॉट। After about 12 days, however, a violent tornado came from the north. The waves rose high, the skies were black, and the wind howled through the sails. Two members of the crew were washed overboard, and after a day or two, the ship began to leak. We changed our course and drove out of the hurricane, but the next day, a second terrible storm attacked us. Robinson Crusoe, with his three crew members, went for a sea journey. Voyage means a journey by a sea or air. So, Robinson Crusoe with his three friends went for a sea journey. At first, all went very well. But then, there is a terrible storm. For 12 days, the wind and the rain didn't stop. We lost, Robinson Crusoe said, we lost three men in the sea. Three men overboard in the sea. And after one day or two days, the ship began to leak. And soon there was many holes occurred in the sides of the ship. Robinson Crusoe thought that now we all are going to die this time. But then one morning, one of the sailors saw land near the sea. But the next few minutes, after few minutes, the ship hit some stone or hard sand just under the sea, and it began to leak. The water enters in the chamber of the ship and it started drown in the sea. The ship couldn't move, and they were really, Robinson Crusoe and his friend become so afraid, and they were really in danger now. The sea was trying to break the ship and drove the Robinson Crusoe and his friends. The ship trying to break the ship into small pieces. The ship was very in angry mood. And we had very little time to save ourselves. So quickly, Robinson Crusoe and his friend put a boat into the sea and go off the ship. Okay? फिर तुरंत रॉबिन्सन क्रूसो और उसके मित्रों ने दूर कहीं एक जमीन देखी और उन्होंने क्या करना चाहा, उन्होंने चाहा कि हम जल्द से जल्द उस जमीन पे, उस कोस्टल एरिया पे पहुंच जाए। ओके, वी कुड सी द शोर ऑफ सम अननोन लैंड, बट द सी वॉज वेरी रफ, द रेन डैश डाउन, एंड वी वर अफ्रेड टू अप्रोच क्लोज टू द लैंड. Our only hope was to clamber into a small boat and try to row to the shore. Four of us managed to get the boat into the sea and we jumped into it. We rowed with all our might, but the waves were like mountains. We struggled on, but at last a gigantic wave, greater than all the others, hurled our little boat into the air and it sank beneath us. But when his friend saw the land nearby the sea, they quickly wanted to put a boat into the sea and go off the ship. But the sea was very rough, the sea was very cruel, and their little boat couldn't live for long in that wild or angry sea. So, half an hour later, the sea turned their boat over and over, and they all were drove in the water. Robinson Crusoe looked here and there for his friend, looked around for his friend, but he couldn't see nobody. Only he see the greater waves, which are just like the height of a mountain. The greater waves again and again comes in front of him, like a gigantic wave, like a height of mountain. So he see here and there to find his friend, but he saw nobody nearby him. He was find himself alone. That day he feel that he was lucky, that he was saved by the cruel sea. In the cruel sea, and the sea hurled his little boat into the air and again sink beneath under the water. Okay, so I am a good sailor. For an hour and a half I battle in that stormy sea. As I catch sight of the coast, a huge wave would lift me up and carry me out to the sea again. Again and again I tried to reach the shore. Again and again I was thrown away by the raging seas. At last, I was hurled toward the shore and fell down exhausted on the sand. He said that approximately half an hour he battled in that stormy sea, he battled in that wild sea, and as he found that he come near the shore again, the water of the sea lift him up, and again the sea carry him under the sea. So again and again he tried to reach the shore, and again the sea drove him under below the water. Then the sea carried him to the shore. Then the sea at last hurled toward the shore and fell down exhausted on the sand. The water of the sea hurled Robinson Crusoe on the shore and he fell down exhausted on the sand. At first he fight with the water of the sea. After approximately half an hour, he couldn't see the land, only the huge waves, only the gigantic waves, which are approximately like the height of mountains. Only mountains of water all around him was there. Then suddenly he felt ground under his feet. Then again another mountain of water came and pushed him up the beach and fell on the wet sand. Actually, why ye? कि बार-बार जब रॉबिन्सन क्रूसो कोशिश कर रहे थे कि वो शोर के पास पहुंचे, सैंड की तरफ पहुंचे, कोस्टल एरिया की तरफ पहुंचे, बार-बार एक जाइजेंटिक वेव माउंटेन लाइक वाटर उसको ठा लेती और वापस से पीछे की तरफ धकेल देती समुद्र के अंदर. फिर वापस से वो कोशिश करते लेकिन वापस से उसको जो समुद्र की लहरें हैं वो पीछे उसको धकेल देती. फिर अचानक एक बड़ी सी समुद्र की लहर आई, उनको उस तरह से राइज अप किया और शोर की तरफ उनको धकेल दिया. एंड आफ्टर दैट ही फेल डाउन एग्जॉस्टेड ऑन द सैंड. The night was dark without a star in the sky, and I knew that lying on the sand would be dangerous. I crawled away from the sea as fast as I could and came to some bushes and trees. I didn't know what wild animals there would be in the forest, so I climbed up on one of the trees and made myself comfortable between two great branches. There I slept the night as well as I could. At first, when he came on the sand, he was very thankful to be alive to the god. And after that, he crawled away from the sea and came to the bushes and trees, because he knew that so many wild animals live in this island. So it would be very dangerous to fell to lie on the sand all night. So he crawled away from the sea to the some bushes and the trees. From there, he looked out the ship, but he found nobody near it. There was nobody in the water. All his friends were dead. He is the only survivor, but in a strange island, he feels so alone. See, he feels so lonely. So he made himself comfortable and he climbed one of the trees nearby the shore. He came between the two great branches of the tree and slept the whole night as he could. In the next morning, I looked out across the sea and there was our ship a quarter of a mile away from the shore. I came down the tree and found a stream where I drank some of the cool fresh water. I lay down and slept again. The sun was high in the sky. When I woke up, I resolved to go out to the ship and to try and bring back some things which would be useful to me on the island. In the next morning, when he woke up, he again looked out across the sea, but he found nobody in the water or nobody near the ship. The ship was approximately a mile away from the shore. So he came down from the tree and found a stream to drink cool and fresh water or to energize himself. Because whole night he spent on the tree and he felt thirsty and very weak. So at first he found a stream of cool and fresh water to energize himself. The sun was high in the sky when he woke up. So he wanted to go out to the ship and try to bring some things like food, water, etc. Because he was the only survivor on this island, on this strange island with no food, no water, no gun. It was dark now and he was tired. He felt afraid in this island, on this island, and he was also afraid from the wild animals of this island. So he went to the ship and tried to bring some things which was useful for him on this island. So when the day came, the sea was quiet again. He looked for his ship and found it was still there, a mile away from the shore. And so he went there to get some food like bread, rice, cheese, and etc. Okay? So, Robinson Crusoe said, "I plunged into the sea and made for the ship. At last, after a hard swim, I managed to reach it and discover a rope hanging over the side. With great difficulty, I pulled myself up the rope and reached the deck. The storm had damaged everything. There were broken masts and torn sails and pieces of rope all over the ship. I went down into the cabins and found an axe. On deck again, I cut the mast and rope and made myself a small raft. I managed to get this raft into the sea and tie it to the vessel with a rope. I found some of the seamen's boxes on board and filled them with stores, bread, rice, cheese, and some wines. So he plunged into the sea. उसने देखा कि समुद्र बिल्कुल शांत है, जहाज अब भी वहीं पे रुका हुआ है, तो उसने समुद्र में गोता मार दिया। After a very hard swim, he reached to the ship. Okay, so he get some useful things from the ship. Then with a great difficulty, he pulled himself up on the deck. Deck means जहाज का जो छत होता है उसको हम डेक कहते हैं। तो बहुत ही मुशक्कत के साथ, बहुत ही डिफिकल्टीज के साथ उसने अपने आप को डेक के ऊपर, यानी कि शिप के, जहाज के छत के ऊपर पहुंचा। आफ्टर स्टॉर्म द शिप बिकम सो मच डैमेज्ड, द स्टॉर्म डैमेज्ड एवरीथिंग ऑन द शिप। देयर वर ब्रोकन मास्ट, देयर वर टॉर्न सेल्स and the pieces of rope all over the ship, here and there. So he went down into the cabin and there he found an axe. After that, he take some broken wood to make a raft. उसने वहां से कुछ टूटी फूटी लकड़ियां ली और उससे छोटी सी एक नाव, एक पतवार बनाया। And then managed to collect the things, useful things, to leave on the island for some time, like bread, rice, cheese, some wines. And also, he found some clothes in the captain's cabin, two guns, a pair of pistols, and some powder and shot. All these I piled onto the raft, and having found a broken oar, I cast off from the vessel and started for the shore. When I reached the sand, I carried the things up on the dry land. Also, with the food, he found some clothes in the captain's cabin. Also, he found gun, pistol, and some powder, gunpowder. Then he collected these all materials onto the raft and again came on the dry land. The next morning, I walked along the shore and up a little hill. From there, I could see that I was on an island. I was a prisoner without a friend in the world. There was no one living on the island but only wild beast. Next morning, when he woke up, he went up a little hillside. वो कुछ ऊंचे इलाके पे गए, and from there, he see that he was on the island with no friend. He feel he was like a prisoner. He feel like himself a prisoner who stuck in on this island without any friends. There was no any living creature exist except the wild animals, wild creatures. The next day, I went back across the sea and brought more stores from the ship. Every day I toiled. I brought tools, wood, rope, nails, sails and clothes, guns and ammunition, and sugar and flour and bread. In one of the wooden boxes, I found gold and silver coins. Sunshine made them sparkle. Next day, he again went back across the sea on the sail, on the ship, and again he bought some tools, wood, rope, nails, sails, clothes, guns, and some bullets or shells. Also, he takes some sugar, flour, and bread also. And at that time, he found a wooden box in which he found a gold and silver coins. But he thought, how could he get it there? He looked around the ship and found many things. Slowly, he found a wooden box filled with some silver and gold coins, which sparkled in the sunshine. Okay? But he asked himself a question, that what use are you to me? Everyone in the world wanted it, but I not, because on this island it is not useful. On this island the food and the clothes are much important than the coins of silver and gold. Okay, when I got back to my island, I noticed that the sky was black. Great clouds rolled up from the west. The rain poured down. I saw the ship out at sea rise and then sink beneath the huge waves. Again, I summarized up. The next morning, he went up a little hill and found he was on an island. He was a feel like a prisoner, without a friend in the world. There was no any living creature on the island, but only wild beasts. Next day, again he went to the ship and took some more useful things. Every day he toiled and do hard work to get the things from the ship to the island. That day, he found a wooden box in which gold and silver coins are there, which sparkled due to the falling sunshine. But he said, "What use are it to me? Everyone in the world doing hard work, doing corruption to get these silver and gold coins. But these coins are not become useful to me. Okay, because on this island, with the help of gold or silver coins, I couldn't buy anything. I couldn't get food or clothes with these coins. So these are no use. These are useless to me." Okay. Again, when he came back to the island, he noticed that the great dark black clouds rolled from the west on the island and started pouring rain down. He saw the ship, which rise for some time and again sink beneath a huge wave under the ship. जैसे ही वो आइलैंड पे पहुंचते हैं, वो देखते हैं कि तूफान जो है, उसने शिप को ऊपर उठाया और वापस से नीचे समुद्र के अंदर उसको डुबा दिया. During the next few months, I busied myself in making a house with a strong stockade around it. I used one of the sails from the ship for the roof. I cut down the tree trunks and carried them to the house and slowly built a strong stockade to keep out wild animals. So he understood. Now he understood that he lived there on this island for a long time, because there is no option to escape from this island. So during the next few months, he made himself busy for doing some hard work, something, etc. So next day he thought about the possible dangers on the island and also the worse weather condition of this island. So he decided to build a very strong house, a strong stockade. Stockade means an enclosure of stakes and timber. लकड़ियों का, मोटी मोटी लकड़ियों का एक enclosure सा figure बनाना, चारों तरफ से घेर के boundary wall करके. So he cut down trees trunk and used sails for roof and wooden and cut wood from the jungle of this island to make the boundary of his house. Thus he built a strong stockade to keep out the wild animals and also to save himself from the worse weather conditions of this island. The month passes in hard work and one day I set out to explore the whole island. The journey took me 3 days, and when I got to the other side of the island, I found a delightful valley. There were wild crabs and limes, and I collected a quantity of these and took them back to my house. One day, in the forest, not far from my house, I found some wild boars. I was just about to shoot one when I saw at my feet a baby boar. I picked it up and carried it home. Then the month passed by doing this work, this hard work. So one day he decided to explore the whole island, to see the whole island, to search the whole island. Then it took 3 days to travel the whole island. When he got to the other side of the island, he found a very beautiful valley, a very delightful valley. And there he found some wild grapes, some limes and other fruits and flowers. Okay, one day near his stockade, he found some wild goats, a herd of wild goats. And just he wanted to shoot one of the goat, he saw a baby goat near his feet, which looked so sensitive, so beautiful. So he postponed his thought to shoot the goat, and he picked that baby goat and carried it here in his house. In a few days, it became quite tame, and after that, it never left my sight. Then, few days, the goat lived with the Robinson Crusoe, and both of them, after that, lived with his company and lived very happy. After a year or two on the island, I decided to make a small boat. I chose the wood carefully and cut and worked the timber for many months. I made a sail from some of the canvas I had bought on shore from the ship, and with a good wind the boat sailed well. After a 1 year or 2 years, he decided to make a small boat with the help of wood which he bought from the ship. So he made a sail from some of the canvas that he bought from the ship. So he built a good and very strong boat which float with a good wind on the sea. I taught myself how to make pots out of mud and how to make them hard and durable by burning them. I grew some corn and rice and also some wheat, and I taught myself to make bread. So after many years, when he was become favorable to live on that island, he was make himself busy by doing many works. Like he taught himself how to make pots and how to make it useful after burning them. He also grew some corn, some rice, some other type of vegetables and weeds. And also he taught himself to make bread. My life on the island was a happy one. I had a good house, plenty to eat and plenty of work to do. He found that his life upon this island became very happy with the company of a baby goat. Now he didn't feel alone himself. He feel very happy because he had a good house, plenty of thing to eat, plenty of work to do. One day I was walking along the seashore, thinking about my house across the sea, when I suddenly looked down. There on the sand in front of me was a clear footprint. It was not mine, but the footprint of another man. Then one day he walked along the bank of the sea, thinking about his own family, thinking about his own city, own area across the sea. Suddenly he looked down on the sand and he found a footprint of some other creature. He found that it is not my footprint, it is a footprint of another man. So there is a possibility that there is another man lived on this island except me. So this is the end of this story. I hope you understand the whole story. The story was not completed in your class because it is only a small portion of the novel written by Daniel Defoe. So if you are interested and wanted to read whole story of this novel, then please purchase the novel of Daniel Defoe, Robinson Crusoe, and please read out the whole story. I hope you will enjoy the whole story. Thank you. Have a nice day. Please do the exercise question on this chapter.